Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. This is Snigdha Mahapatra, Internet LexClick, and in today's video I will be talking about duties and role of director. What are the duties of the director? Duties of a director to the company may be categorized into fiduciary duties which arise because directors are quasi-trustees of the assets of the company, and duties of skill and care which arise at common law and are in respect of the law of negligence. What are fiduciary duties? A director must account to the company any personal profits he may take in the course of dealing with the company's property. For example, if a director buys shares in the company at par, which he has sold at a profit, he must account for such profit. The reason for this is that there has been a conflict of interest in such a scenario. When a director in the course of his employment obtains a contract for himself, is liable to account to the company for the profit he makes, even if it can be shown that the company would not necessarily have obtained the contract. The accountability arises from the mere fact that a profit is made by the director and it is not a question of loss to the company. A director is not accountable for the profits for a competing business which he may be running unless the article of his service contract expressly so provides that he will be accountable if he uses the company's property in that business, or if he uses its trade secrets or induces the company's customers to deal with him. A director is not allowed to use either during or after deal with the company confidential information entrusted to him by the company. A director may keep a personal profit if the company consents, but the consent must be given by the members in a general meeting and not by the board and resolution in the general meeting. However, a director may take advantage of a corporate opportunity on his own account. If his company considered the same proposition and rejected it in good faith, directors must use their power to proper purposes that benefits the company and not to further their own interests. In industrial development consultants versus Cooley, the director of IDC pretended to be ill, owing to which IDC determined his employment immediately, and the director then obtained Eastern Gas Board contract for the 4 depots for himself. The court held that the director had acted in breach of duty and must account if he had tried and regulates to change the mind of EGB so that the company has ruined losses. In Genco ACP Limited versus Dalby, it was held that a director has fiduciary duties if he has made profits. He will be held liable to account for it to the company. Whether the company would or would not have obtained the profit is irrelevant. In Regal Hastings Limited versus Gulliver, the court held that the directors will be liable to the company once it is established that what the directors did relate to the affairs of the company to such an extent that one day he said to have been in the course of their management and utilization of their opportunities is special knowledge obtained by them by virtue of being directors. Second, that what they did resulted in a profit to them. These principles were laid down in Broadman versus Fipes and were followed in the above case as well. Duties of skill and care. The doctor also owes a duty of care to the company in common law to not act negligently in managing its affairs. The directors are that of a reasonable man in looking after his own gallery or affairs. The UK standard of care is being derived from the law relating to wrongful trading by directors. Section 214 of the Insolvency Act 1986 provides for personal liability for directors in such account as the court may decide in an insolvent liquidation as a contribution to the company's debts. In our city, Ray City Equitable Fire Insurance Company, which is a case that is concerned with the duties of directors, where it has been said that the directors of the insurance had left the management of its affairs almost entirely to the chairman, and that was the main reason there was a perpetration of his frauds. It was held that in the company, the directors have to follow the duties of care, skill, and the course of employment. Duties to employees. The company has a power to make any person for its employee which is ordinarily approved by an ordinary resolution. However, this does not apply if the memorandum or the articles contain a provision whereby the power can be exercised by director's resolution or a special resolution. A duty of directors towards employees complies with the requirement of employment law generally. Duties to shareholders. The director does not have any contractual or fiduciary relations with members of their company, generally speaking. The stock exchange, with consultation with CBI, published a model code for securities transactions to give proper guidance as to when it is proper for directors of listed companies to deal in the securities of the company. This code received widespread acceptance and became part of the listing agreement. Duties to creditors. In a solvent company, the shareholder is given as the natural body which is registered, which is or regarded as company when questions of the duty of directors arise. However, where a company is insolvent, the interests of the creditors unrule. They have power, though, in solvency procedures to control the company's assets, which are in a practical sense director assets and not shareholder assets. Duties to other outsiders. There is no fiduciary or contractual duty to outsiders if the company breaks its contract. When the directors make the contract on behalf of the company, they may be liable for the breach of warranty. In weeks versus profit, the company borrowed some money in excess of its borrowing powers, so that the pants are ultra vires. It was held that there was a breach of warranty against the directors. The directors were held liable when they have made an ultra vires contact with a contract that would bind the company, and such connected person may bring a claim for a breach of warranty against the directors. Thank you so much for watching the video. Please subscribe to the channel and see you in another video.